हेलो एवरीवन, वी आर डूइंग द सेकेंड चैप्टर ऑफ SST, एस्टैब्लिशमेंट ऑफ रूल ऑफ ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी इन इंडिया. द प्रीवियस चैप्टर वी सॉ द लॉर्ड वेलेसली, द गवर्नर हु मेड अ सब्सिडरी ट्रीटी सिस्टम एंड हिज टर्म्स एंड कंडीशंस. एंड वी सॉ द मराठा डिनास्टी, हाउ इट गॉट एंड विद द वॉर ऑफ बिटवीन ब्रिटिश एंड मराठास. एंड द न्यू गवर्नर Hastings and William Bentinck were appointed for the Bengal, and they did a lot of reformation. They did a lot of reform in the field of economic and the other administrative for the country. So now we will be seeing how they were working for the welfare of the administrative and the in the field of economics. William Bentinck was known for the most reformer governor general. And he was a believer of peace instead of war. So we see previously, Lord Wellesley, he is to declare a war and he is to make them sign a subsidiary alliance or whatever treaty. He was forcing the Nawabs or Sultans to sign the treaty. But here we see the William Bentinck, he is a believer, means he doesn't trust in the war. He just believes in the peacemaking with another country. With peace we can solve a lot of problems. So here, due to that constant war was happening, what happened that the economic condition of the company was not stable. A lot of losses were happening because of war. So what he decided to change something for the condition of the company, he told we should change this system of war. And he decreased lot of soldiers, because lot of soldiers were there, lot of troops were there. What did he do? He cut short the annual expenses of administration. Means lot of expenses were happening or to be spent behind the soldiers and the troops, because lot of injuries were happening for their food expenses, and there were lot of number of soldiers. So he decrease the number of the soldiers, and the annual expenses were cut short. So most of the expenses were saved in them. So the Indian officials were mostly appointed for doing a lot of administration. For collecting the revenue, he used to add the which policy? Todel Mar policy. So this policy system of collection was for the fixed 30 years. He fixed the taxation for 30 years, and he also used to fix the different types of grains, crops, for different items. He used to fix the prices so that no other changes, no other losses will happen to these traders or the other people, those who are doing farming. So he took special care towards social evils like sati, child marriage, human sacrifice, and formed a law to abolish this. So he changed all these evil practices what was happening. Like we saw sati, they used to, the wife whose husband died, they had to give their lives. And the child marriage, who had to marry the old people, and the human sacrifices were also done. And he abolished, means he removed these types of system, and he made a strict rule not to practice like this. So he made something a strict rule or restrictions to do this act. So he made English the medium of education. So English medium was introduced in his time. A lot of people got education in English, because many do not know. And he established a medical college in Kolkata. So he started a medical college in Kolkata. In 1831, he passed the law, and that he propounded eligibility of Indians to take charge in higher officials. Many of the Indians were not given opportunity to take. Many of the Indians were not given opportunity to take as officials, higher officials. So here the higher officials were appointed or eligible for now can take part in a lot of other system of administration. So he constructed national highways and bridges. Lot of transportation was easier. Now he has made lot of roads, highways, bridges, and a lot of progress was happening because of this administration he was doing. After the decline of Marathas, British were unable to capture complete India except few places of Punjab and Sindh. Only Sindh and Punjab was remaining. Other lot of other parts were captured by Britishers, because we saw that Maratha dynasty got ended with the war of Britishers. They were defeated and most of the central India was captured by the Britishers, but Punjab and Sindh was remaining. By the end of the 1818, we saw the agitation between the company was almost finished. I mean, lot of hesitation, lot of afraid for the other problems of war was finished, because lot of things were sorted by the administration. So, but we see that England and Russia were the rivals. They were fighting against each other, and they were also coming for capturing the other parts of the India. So the Britishers were afraid that Russia might enter India through Afghanistan, because we see that Sindh is nearby, is attached to the Sindh, Afghanistan. So if they enter, then they can capture the part of India. So they were afraid of that. So what did they do? They made to sign the subsidiary treaty to Amir of Sindh. They forced him to sign the treaty. Now that it came, so now the Sindh is under the British control. Now no other countries or so now no other countries can capture that. So it is under the control of the Britishers. So in the same way, Punjab was a strong state under the leadership of Ranjit Singh. But after his death, Punjab also was attacked in 1849, and it was captured by whom? By the Britishers again. Now most of the parts are captured by Britishers. So on those days, Lord Dalhousie was the new Governor General of India. So he adopted very cruel way of administrating the things. He was forcing people to rule. He was forcing people to follow his administration, his policies. So he dominated the states of India. Most of the states he was dominating and he was taking under his control. So he forced the different state to act according to his three policies. So what were his three policies? So the first one was doctrine of lapse. So the first policy he adopted was doctrine of lapse. So those kings who had no sons or maybe no successors, or they have adopted different children, so they cannot rule that state. So it will come under the control of Britishers. So that was the first doctrine of lapse he introduced. And the second policy was capturing of those states which had poor governance. So those who were having poor governance, those who were not having good, strong soldiers or troops, so they were taken under the control of Britishers. And the third policy was authorizing the states through wars. So those states which were not agreeing to his policies, what he used to do? He used to declare war against them, and he used to take the states under his control. So through these policies, he assimilated Satara, Jaitpur, Jhansi, Nagpur, Udaipur, etc. So many states, so many different places which was not under him, he declared war, and different with these three policies, he controlled the whole of these places and states by his control under him. So by his second policy, he assimilated Awadh. Again, by his second policies, we see capturing the states through the poor governance. There was a poor governance in Awadh, so he captured the Awadh by adapting the second policies. And by winning the battle against Punjab, it was also assimilated under the British policies. So Punjab, after losing the battle, was under the control of British here. So during the period of Lord Dalhousie, some reformation was taken place. We'll see here. So what about the reformation? Like postage, the post means letters and all were postage, telegrams, then transport and traffic control system, and improvement in communication, and formation of education board. So these are some of the reformations that took place under his leadership. In 1853, the first train between Mumbai to Thane, we see it came in year 1853. So mainly this development was mainly for their benefits, but slowly slowly it came under the control and administration of the country, and also the collection of the raw materials and manufacturing it into products was the result of all the development of the country was rapid. So lot of reformations and development was taking because of this all the developments that he has done. Later on it came after his leadership was ended, other people who applied this development for the people, and therefore the faster development was happening in the country. So due to this policy of Lord Dalhousie, disappointed among many Indian rulers who were living there day by day, and in 1853 the revolution was taken place in the that we'll be seeing in the next chapter.